Hello everyone. So this is the summary of the poem "When I Have Fears That I May Cease to Be" by Joan Keats. So this poem is actually a sonnet written by Joan Keats. This poem was written in 1818, 3 years before the poet's death in 1821, and was published in 1848 in the collection "Life Letters and Literary Remains of Joan Keats." This poem is about poet's fear of death. Come to the text of the poem. So the poem opens with these lines: "When I have fears that I may cease to be, before my pen has gleaned my teeming brain." Okay, so here poet means to say that he is worried that what will happen when he dies. Okay, when he dies, before recording his thoughts and ideas into his poems. Okay, before expressing his thoughts and ideas into his poems. "Before high-piled books in charactery hold like rich garners the full ripened grain." And now poet is saying that what will happen if he dies before piling up so many books, you know, by recording his thoughts and ideas into those books. And now he compares this activity of piling up books with the farmer who piles up harvested grain in his storehouse. And then he says, "When I behold upon the night star face huge cloudy symbols of high romance and think that I may never live to trace their shadows with the magic hand of chance." And now he says that when he looks up into the sky full of stars, he sees a lot of love and romance. He sees a lot of symbols of love and romance, and he fears of having died before recording this beautiful experience in his poems. Okay. And think that I may never live to trace the shadows with the magic hand of chance, that he won't be able to translate his thoughts and ideas and such beautiful experiences into poems, you know, before his death. "And when I feel fair creature of an hour that I shall never look upon thee more." And then he says that he fears that after his death, he won't be able to see the beautiful face of his beloved and won't be able to enjoy the magical power of their love. Okay, the fairy power of unreflecting love. "Then on the shore of the wide world, I stand alone and think till love and fame to nothingness do sink." Okay, so when these thoughts of death start weighing upon his mind, then poet starts feeling alone and isolated, and he feels as if he's standing alone on a seashore, and then he thinks that, you know, love and fame are nothing before time, because everything is subjected to death. Okay, and everything is subjected to death and decay. And here the poem ends.